Okay, first what we do, we add TAE buffer, and this 1x TAE, and we pour it so that it covers the gels. And that should be enough. So what we do, in this case, we gently and slowly remove these holders so that we do not damage the gels. And after we did it, and after we removed it, we place it in our running buffer. And next gel. Today we are going to cast to run 4 gels. 2 of them will be with a fluorescent dye, 2 without. Okay, so these 2 gels are too big, so we add some more TAE buffer before we start loading the wells. Okay, so we start with the crimson. Okay, so we take, first we have our standard digest. And we add it to the first well. before you start pouring it inside the wells, you have to mix them thoroughly by pipetting up and down without making bubbles. When you're done, you can use your second hand so that the tip of the pipette is not tremoring, and you can place it precisely inside the well. Then you go with the crime scene. And you use the same amount. And you also thoroughly mix it by pipetting up and down. Release it very slowly because you don't want all of your sample to counter heat the well and float outside. Make sure that you remember the order you place the samples in the wells. Wait for everyone, and next we will be showing you how to set up the power supply.